Okay, it's day 127.2, and already I'm getting criticisms of, "Hey, George, where do you get this idea that there's all these Russian gymnasts in Jason's ex-wife's building?" And there was this spa I was telling you about, and when you're waiting for people, you just kind of look around and listen to conversations. And I can't understand much Russian, but there's these Russian conversations going on near this spa, and a lot of diminutive, pretty girls. They look like gymnasts, so that's where I got that impression. I don't have any proof beyond that. But what I do know is we did run, Task Force and I ran this background check on Bogacheva. And this picture comes up, and this is Westerman from the law firm of Rostova and Westerman. This is Debbie Wasserman Schultz's EB-5 law firm. So we got a hit here with Debbie Wasserman Schultz in the Diplomat Hotel. So just re to remind you who she is, she has a job speaking Russian that ends, it begins in 2015 to May 2016. This is sort of right around the time of Seth Rich, right? At Florida International University. That's where Bernie Wisenant's wife taught. That's where Bernie Wisenant's wife taught. We went there. Jason and I went there. Again, all these things can be verified through Jason's films as well as mine. But if you want to go back, she starts at this Veronica Panoff, PA. And I thought that was Pennsylvania for some reason. And I thought, I better go back and check because I remembered it was September 1st, 2013, which is right before September 11th, obviously, to September 1st, 2014. I thought, oh, that's interesting that it would end there because 10 days later is the explosion down there, or the fake explosion down in Centreville in Louisiana. So I'm like, huh, I better drill down on this Veronica Panoff. So I do, and here's Veronica Panoff, and guess what? It's not Pennsylvania, it's Hannondale, Florida, right? And just to drill down a little bit, let's talk about EB-5s, let's talk about visas, let's talk about green cards. Well, that makes sense. You'd want to bring a Russian lawyer in to do that sort of thing, to do EB-5s and so forth. So let's just find out where their business address is, okay? We'll go down a little bit, and there's different folks commenting about her green card, citizenships, and so forth. And let's see where she actually is. Well, okay, she's at 1920 Hallandale Beach Boulevard. Well, let's chart that. Okay, so let's chart and see where 1920 Hannondale is. Well, it's right there around the corner from where I was saying all these Russian girls are at this spa. And I thought, huh, that's interesting because this is where Miami Mama was, right around the corner, right on that same thing. I remember we turned here, there was this elevated highway, and we had turned and we went inland, but I can't remember exactly. But this is where we went with Miami Mama, and I went with Jason's ex and Jason. Okay, this we went right by this office, and that's where she worked. Now, is this not the full service get your Russian girls here service? I mean, the Miami Mama was raided by the FBI for bringing in young kids. And the reason why I say gymnasts is because the person that led this group that I've been covering in St. Petersburg had this weird history with Putin. Getting these Russian gymnasts, always consumed with these Russian gymnasts. It was called Nasi or Nashi or something like that. So if you don't remember, there was this group of 13 people that are in the indictment, and this is this Prigozhin, or however you say his name. And this 13 group of people is translators, psychologists, and inventors. I said, this is Fusion GPS in Russia. basically, it's this kind of group of how do we get all the intellectual capital out and sell it, selling England by the pound kind of thing. This is the selling England by the pound group. Psychologists for the kids, the inventors for the intellectual property, this translators to make it all happen. And then there's this guy, okay, who's running the whole show, the 13. And I knew there was something in his background that's Prigozhin, okay. He's the guy who runs this internet news agency at Savoshkina that I've been talking about, right? And here's where the payoff comes because you get rewarded for all the good work and attention because it's a little complicated. But he's the chef of Putin. He winds his way up to be the chef of Putin, all right? And so that's how the Western media knows him. But I'm like, no. He's not. That's not how he started. He's a hot dog guy. He started with kids. He started getting minors involved in prostitution. He was a finder. And I'm pretty sure this is kind of a George Bush finder. And to kind of track with Putin, he goes all the way back to when Putin was the deputy mayor of St. Petersburg, I believe. So going back a long way. So him and Putin go back a long way, and Putin has kind of been supported, I think, by George Bush on the way up. But he's been a fighter for a long time. So anyway, you remember what I said about fusion centers, and I'm trying to draw these things together slowly, but the thing that's wrong with fusion centers, both in the United States as well as in Russia, is you gather all these pictures and photos of kids and whatnot, or people that you don't like, and you then can like sell them or destroy them or whatever. And so that's the point I was trying to make with this thing. And this guy had wanted to wipe his history clean. So he had spent all kinds of money trying to pack a courtroom to get his name off this Russian search index, which is called Yandex. And there's always a reason. And it was to suppress this article here, the right to be forgotten, because he was a finder. So if you go back to the map again, you're seeing all this kind of finding right around the corner. Now, I'm not saying Bogacheva, the Miami lawyer, is involved in this, but I think Bogacheva, the Russian lawyer, is involved. And if that's the one that ends up at this law firm right here, then I'm going to say that's the first place I'd look if I was an investigator, if I was a police investigator. Look how close all this is, how tight all this is. Now, if you're going to be working with a finder, and this guy's been a finder, right? Pritzkovan has been a finder since when? 1979? He's been doing this, and he rises to power by finding supposedly these Russian girl gymnasts for Putin. And Putin's very nationalistic in terms of wanting, these great athletes. And just to show you how close he is to Putin, he's, kind of, follows Putin everywhere. Now, I don't think he's actually a chef. I think he's actually just Putin's body man. He's kind of assigned by our intelligence agencies and so forth. And there's that famous Savushkina location. And if you go through the list of all 13 of these people, it reads like a fusion GPS. I mean, you may as well put Bruce Orr's a name on one thing, and then put Nellie Orr on another, and all the journalists that they buy. The only difference with the Fusion GPS and Savushkina operation, this 13 folks, is a couple of them worked in different buildings. There was a New York Times reporter in New York, a Washington Post reporter in Washington, rather than in Savushkina. They're all in the same building. But if you were doing finding, if you've been doing finding for 35 years or 38 years now for these Russian gymnasts or Ukrainian gymnasts or Romanian gymnasts, and you recruit these Bella Scirolis or whatever his name is, Karolis, and you're bringing in all these gymnasts, and then you're having all these parties and so forth, and you're doing all these EB-5s, why wouldn't you have a location a little bit farther, a kind of a parkland location a little bit farther away, where you could kind of keep like a pen, a cattle pen? And it's out near Mar-a-Lago, so we can introduce people to the folks out in Mar-a-Lago. Here, we'll just add it in here. And then I'll just show you how close Mar-a-Lago is to parkland. We'll add in 80, excuse me, 6160 Northwest Terrace, and just show you how far it is. There's about 30 miles away, and then there's Mar-a-Lago right there. So you have kind of your initial way of introducing the girls to sports figures, celebrities, and so forth in the United States. And then you just bring them down here for Bogacheva if you have any diplomats coming into the diplomat hotel. And then you try to sell them on condos in Trump Hollywood.